Finally tonight, we're probably witnessing the end of what was an incredibly popular Australian pastime. It wasn't all that long ago that future world squash champions were playing on suburban courts all over this country. But now they're almost as rare as drive-in theatres. Here's Leanne West.
Ken Hisko is a pioneer of Australian squash, one of just four players granted official legend status in the game's Hall of Fame.
Two of the world's greatest squash players, Jeff Hunt in the forehand court and Ken Hisko playing the backhand, bring you this coaching series on squash, one of the most exciting and fastest growing indoor sports in the world.
It's amazing how many people did play squash. You know, people of our age and our bracket, nearly everyone played squash.
Those were the golden days when world champions like Jeff Hunt and Heather Mackay were household names, when it seemed like there was a squash court on every corner. But the vast majority of courts were privately owned, prime pickings for property developers.
Unfortunately, courts have disappeared purely and simply because of the price of land.
Fellow legend and three-time world champion Michelle Martin knows all too well. It recently happened to the local courts where she'd been coaching.
It has now been shut down, there's big gates up around it, and he's getting it rezoned to put, you know, housing facilities on it. And when these facilities go now, they're not coming back. It's tragic.
There's no definitive statistics on the number of squash centres around Australia that have gone the way of this one. But some figures from New South Wales give us a pretty good idea. In 1985, there were 157 clubs playing in the Sydney Pennant competition. This year, there's 39.
For the centres that remain, it's often a case of diversify or die. 30 years ago, Ken Hisko built Sydney's then showpiece squash centre. These days, it's still a vibrant business, but half of the nine original squash courts now host gym equipment.
Cold, hard business reality, yeah. That the amount of people that you can put on this space in a gym class or working on machines compared to two squash players for an hour on the court.
Both Hisko and Martin believe their game slide in popularity has plateaued. They point to continuing international success from our leading players. But the game's greats also agree that squash has to work hard to shore up its future.
We have to somehow get some more courts so we can incorporate more young kids into the programs. We have the coaches, we have the people prepared to do the time. It's the courts that are the problem.
I don't know whether I can name many other sports that are provided by private operators. They're all council facilities. And so that's what we are needing more of. We need more local government support to bring our sport back up to where it should be.
The golden days might be gone.
And that's it, that's the game to Hunt.
But the door's far from closed on the game they love.
The argument there for me is, you know, you build the facilities and they will come. And I can guarantee you they will come because there's so many people out there that still want to play the sport